a priceless collection of Yuan Dynasty blue and white porcelain. The raw materials for imitation are hard to find. The vault was opened and the truth recorded. The most skilled artisans challenge the limits as they try to clone these treasures. Join us for part 3, The Allure of Blue and White. The magical appearance of the 19 Yuan Dynasty blue and white porcelain items turned the Gaoan Museum into the keeper of the world's third largest collection of this kind of ceramic. Only Turkey's Topkapi Palace and Iran's Ardabil Shrine have more examples of this type of porcelain. But their origin remains a mystery. Blue and white porcelain is white porcelain decorated under a glaze with a natural cobalt blue pigment. Fired at a temperature of over 1200 degrees Celsius in one pass, it takes on an alluring blue translucent pattern. That's why it's called blue and white porcelain. Exquisite and rare, it's extremely precious. Even in Jingdezhen, the capital of porcelain, there are few such items to be found these days. How could so many of them suddenly turn up in Gaoan? In ancient times, Gaoan was a very remote place. If the porcelain had been passed down over the centuries, why are there no written records? Some suspect that these vases are imitations produced in Jingdezhen. As the porcelain capital of the world, Jingdezhen plays an indispensable role in the ceramic arts, but has also reached a peak in the high-quality imitations and counterfeits. Xiong Biru is a senior ceramic artisan in Jingdezhen. He has rich experience in the production of ceramics. He also has been part of the production chain of imitations, so he has a special perspective when it comes to imitations and counterfeits. Although the provenance of the Gaoan Yuan blue and white porcelain hasn't been verified, curator Liu Jingchun has always believed the items to be genuine. To create a display exhibit, and also to try to prove that even the most skilled faker can make a perfect duplicate of one of the Yuan and blue and white items, Liu invites Xiong to try to reproduce one of the items kept in the Gaoan Museum. Liu opens the museum's vault to Xiong so he can observe and examine the items. Rich knowledge and experience of Yuan blue and white, Xiong still marvels at the collection when he faces it directly in the vault. Xiong concludes that the pieces are genuine. They're not modern fakes. So is it true that today's craftsmen can't duplicate Yuan blue and white? to Dunn, many craftsmen imitate ancient porcelain using pictures. They rarely have the chance to see genuine items.
用原生花的一些结构，比如那个布局，就是纹饰，有的是刺激乱画的，有的是正面，没有背面，还有乱画，你知道吧？本来这个形是这样的，他另外画一套。
Even if the craftsmen have to make up the patterns using their imagination, they rarely worry about anyone noticing. Therefore, it's only when the genuine item and the copy are viewed simultaneously that the differences become obvious. But this hardly ever happens. That's why Jing Dijun imitations produced using different skill levels have a wide market. But this time, the craftsman's imitations will be compared with the genuine article side by side. Any differences will be seen right away. Xiong decides to accept the challenge and try his best to make imitation versions of one or more of the Gaoan items.
包括它的那个造型的精确尺寸，哪一个地方是最小的，哪一个地方是最大？比如说镀金的最大点在什么地方？不仅轮椅的器物产品出来以后，但是我说不行，你要把它打烂，给我埋掉。There
was every reason to be cautious. This is the first time he has shown the entire collection to an imitator. If the imitations got onto the market, there would be a scandal. The most important step when imitating ancient porcelain is to find the same materials that were used for the original copies. But this is a huge challenge now that more than 700 years have passed. The mineral used to draw Yuan blue and white porcelain is called smog.
这个蒙元帝国，它势力很强大，横跨欧亚两洲。材料，当时呢，我们古料是要依靠波斯一些国家进口来。The
Yuan Empire had a vast territory and often traded with Central Asian countries. So this magic mineral found its way to China. It was very expensive because it came from such faraway places.
它的料就限制了我们产量。但我刚才也说到了，一克的黄金泛不到一克的青料。那么就是说呢，The
patterns on the surface of the Gaoan collection look fresh and vary in gradations of color. In some patterns, where the smalt has piled up, the iron in the pigment has turned into rust spots under high temperatures and gives a dark purple shimmer. These rust spots form naturally under the glaze, like tiny pieces of iron burnt into the base. They look and feel quite bumpy. Only with the ancient smalt is there a chance of ending up with the final colors close to the original. But can Xiong find this particular mineral pigment? These days,
ancient Persian smoke is impossible to get a hold of. But the modern chemical industry can determine its composition and create similar substances through complicated mixing. This is a highly technical task. The price of cobalt pigments varies greatly according to its complexity and effects. The best sells for tens of thousands of yuan per kilogram. However, when Shom finishes painting the vase with the expensive and hard-to-obtain pigment and fires it, he finds that the result is well beyond his expectations. According to today's technical standards, pigment should be completely integrated into the body without any hollows or bumps. But hundreds of years ago, the techniques were not mature, so hollows formed where pigments piled up. Originally, it was considered to be a technical flaw, but today, how well an imitator can replicate these flaws is an indicator of his skill. Which pigment should be used to make it as bumpy as the genuine article? Through a statistical survey, Sean gradually finds the correct quantity. Where the chemical pigments were applied in the way he expected, he can feel continuous hollows and bumps, and see cold dark blue shimmering in the hollows.
铁锈斑的这个味道跟原来已经差不多，但是呢，从整体效果来讲，跟原先的比还是有一定的距离。是当时乐州路的行政首脑以及行政长官，他就必须要有这个少数民族，也就是我们蒙古族人担任。那么呢，他可能才有与我们景德镇比邻的这个我高安与景德镇比邻的。
With no written evidence, this can only be Liu's speculation. The identity of the real owner remains a mystery. How can the lines be made so graceful and elegant? Xiong has been looking for a method to recreate the blurry effect.
刚刚博物馆的它那个东西呢，它有一点点晕散，晕散又不很厉害，就是说它那个釉有一定的厚度，而且火候呢刚好在那个地方，它晕散点，它就停下来了。
Now, we can compare the original piece with the imitation. As far as appearances go, there's barely any difference in either shape or design.
From the design perspective, it's basically 符合高文馆我们馆藏的那个云间牡丹礼品，整个这个布局还是与原件的呢，没有较大的差距。
原作品它不是均匀分布的，每一个之间的距离我们都是从原作上量下来的，而且每一个炉翼里面的海涛纹，这里面几个我们也是几个，就是说我们遵从老祖宗的。不能有刺激任何东西带进去。
Secondly, let's examine the difference in the color of the pattern, which covers most of the vase.
又比较清晰，又能晕散一点，能动一点，但是又恰到好处，这个非常难。
云还是虽然靠近，但是还是达不到真品釉面的那种效果。那么所以说呢，这个是呢，可能是在某种配方上的缺陷，以及古代一些配方的失传有关。
To the trained eyes of professional appraisers, the color of the two items looks slightly different. But for ordinary people, the imitation is quite perplexing.Especially without the original available for comparison. People could definitely be easily cheated with the imitation. Having closely studied the genuine items in the Gaoan Museum during the imitation process, Zhang noticed one thing that modern imitators can never achieve.
元秋画的，尤其是他的画艺，他的绘画，他的绘画呢，就是线条，他尽管是很粗犷，但是很飘逸、流畅。
我们要去模仿人的字体，很拘谨，心里先紧张，下笔就拘谨。
现在所仿的东西，就是大部分绘画的人呐、啊，他都是只是仿到了一个形，画的一个形，而且形不准，他的神韵达不到。
Even the senior ceramic artisan whose limitations have
瓷器，主要要从五个方面。第一，我要看它的胎，它的再看它的釉，看它的形，然后看它的装饰。装饰包括它的色彩，包括它的纹样，另外再要看它的底足，底足要看它的装烧工艺、削足工艺，工艺技术留给我们的时代信息。
它的釉和料特别好，它的釉呢很薄，但是非常肥润，清晰度非常好。
这众多的这么方面，它都具备元代的特征，那我们才能断定它是这个时期的文物。如果有一处，我们有怀疑，我们都不敢轻易的下结论。
There are dragon patterns on this Gaoan jar. There are similar dragon patterns on this jar with the lotus leaf shaped cover, and these three vases. Could these vases with dragon designs have belonged to the Yuan imperial family? If so.How did they find their way to a place like Gaoan?
老百姓如果用的这个东西要砍头，或者是。
Huang Zhengping, a retired teacher who lives in Gaoan, has been looking for the descendants of the owner of the cellar. He's tracked down a family with the surname Wu. The family's genealogy.And the records surprise him. Quite a number of people in the family held important posts in different historical periods.
Fu Ma Du Wei, 五梁, 五星谱。先看一下，哦，对，这里，好好好。
Wu Xingpu was born in Gaoan in 1266. In 1302, at the age of 36, he passed the Imperial Martial Arts Examination at the provincial level and later became the Emperor's son-in-law. In 1325, he died in Gaoan at the age of 59.
因为这个教堂它肯定是它是贡品，也是飞到家乡带回来。
During the Yuan Dynasty, the only family in Gaoan related to the imperial family was the Wu family. As the dragon patterns on the vases seem to be a sign of the imperial family, did they really belong to Wu?
双脚无爪，它是禁止鱼。那么，国家有法规定，你所以你下边你浮梁瓷器、匠足院什么的，你都不能够违背这个，所以你就不能画五爪龙。画的话就是三爪四爪。
Dragons with two horns and five claws were the exclusive symbol of the emperors. Since the dragons on the porcelain have either three or four claws.The experts refute the speculation that they belong to the imperial family. The most likely owners are the magistrate of the prefecture and the Wu family. However, due to the lack of written evidence, the experts can't come to a final conclusion. The identity of the true owner remains a mystery.700 years ago,The Yuan Empire covered a vast territory. The ancestors of the Chinese people visited the blue mosques of Central Asia and brought back some of the blue pigment used to color them. It was called smalt, and after it was fired in Chinese kilns, the Han and Islamic cultures began to merge in the production of ceramics. These beautiful blue designs were fixed to Chinese pottery bases. From then on,Blue and white porcelain became an integral part of Chinese culture. 19 yuan blue and white porcelain and 4 yuan red underglaze items fill ceramic experts with excitement. Although few have the opportunity to hold them in their own hands, those who have seen them never hesitate to praise them using the most beautiful words.Gaoan is a small...